New tonight, an I-Team exclusive. As calls for a demand for policing changes continue, our Washington Bureau spent the last month analyzing how police use federally issued military equipment and body cameras.
And the I-Team's Samantha Manning looked at hundreds of law enforcement agencies, including some right here in the Miami Valley.
I've spent the last few weeks talking to hundreds of police chiefs, sheriffs, and other law enforcement officials all over the country. Many of them say limited local funding plays a role in their access to programs and equipment.
George Floyd!
A movement sparked by brutality.
They breathe.
We have awakened the conscience of our nation.
Now a nationwide call for police reform. There isn't currently a national database when it comes to many police practices. So we created our own.
Samantha Manning calling.
We contacted law enforcement agencies here and in areas across the country where we have sister stations, more than 400 in total. We found around 38% of law enforcement agencies use body cameras. Less than 10% have citizen review boards to review cases involving use of force. And around half use surplus military equipment from the federal government. Here in the Dayton area, around 20% of the agencies who responded use body cameras, and around half of them have surplus military equipment.
The military is already effectively in cities and towns around the country. That's what this analysis shows me.
We brought our findings to the Lawyers Committee for Civil Rights under Law.
I would think that there would have been more jurisdictions that had access to body-worn cameras.
Many of the chiefs and sheriffs I spoke with say it comes down to money. They can't afford the cost of body cameras or the video storage. They say that limited funding also plays a role in the use of surplus military equipment through a program with the Pentagon. I spoke with Houston Police Chief Art Acevedo, the president of the Major Cities Chiefs Association.
We have to remove the emotion from a lot of these conversations.
Records from our investigation show dozens of agencies have armored vehicles. In some cases across the country, they've been used to help local police respond to recent protests. Our departments say they use them in flooding and other weather events.
What do you say to people who are concerned about local law enforcement agencies becoming militarized?
Well, I would say that they need to go no further than Dayton, Ohio. Some deranged killer went on a shooting spree. It was a Dayton police officer with a military assault style rifle that we call patrol rifles that was able to take that man down.
I'm not going to say all out get rid of it, but the fact that there is so much of it on the streets and in different police departments around the country is concerning.
And while only a few of the agencies we spoke with use citizen review boards to review cases involving use of force, many say they have advisory committees. Those are meant to give community input on police practices. In Washington, Samantha Manning, News Center 7.